Pope Francis has given a final blessing to Cardinal George Pell at a funeral mass at the Vatican. The controversial cardinal's body will now be returned to Sydney to be buried in a crypt at St Mary's Cathedral.
The Vatican pays a final farewell to the late Cardinal George Pell at St Peter's Basilica.
L'anima del cardinale George Pell.
We are here united to entrust Cardinal George Pell's soul to God, said Cardinal Giovanni Battista Re.
Now he is in the full redemption.
The final blessing was given by Pope Francis, who Pell accused of creating a catastrophe for remaining silent on LGBTQ members of the church and female priests. Pell died after a cardiac arrest on Tuesday following hip surgery.
We were really close and it was a shock for me when I heard of his death.
Pell was born in Ballarat in Victoria and was ordained a priest in 1966. He was the highest ranking Catholic to be found guilty of the child sexual abuse of two choir boys in the mid-1990s. He served 404 days in prison before his conviction was overturned in 2020 by the High Court of Australia. But that same year, he was found to have failed to act on complaints about pedophile priests.
And he admitted that himself to the Royal Commission, that he didn't do enough.
But I had no reason to turn my mind to the extent of the evils.
Yet he has been celebrated for overhauling the Vatican's finances.
He tried to clean up the Vatican because it wasn't the most ideal institution, and he tried to, you know, make it a bit less corrupt.
The congregation broke into a round of applause as the service concluded. The Cardinal's body will now be repatriated to Australia, where it will be buried in the crypt beneath St Mary's Cathedral in Sydney. A memorial service will be held, but there will be no state funeral. Nor in his home state of Victoria.
So I couldn't think of anything that would be more distressing for victim survivors than that.
George Pell was 81. Sarah Navin for 10 News First.